Hi there, and greetings from lockdown, and how are you surviving it? I was just kind of thinking, how would I survive if I was still drinking now? And I think the answer to that would be, it would be quite difficult. We're in unprecedented times, and it's quite difficult to predict what will happen during this time. It's quite difficult to predict how people will behave. You know, one of the surprises, and maybe it shouldn't have been, but it was to me anyway, was that quite a lot of drinkers and their partners are actually sitting down and talking. They're, and I don't mean just chatting, I mean there's some really quite meaningful discussions going on. One of the things I think that's happening with this coronavirus is that people are beginning to realise what's important, what's really not important. And because of that, they're starting to look and say, well, okay, one of the big important things is relationships. And because of that, let's have a wee look and see how this relationship is working out. And some of them are finding it's not working out so well because of drinking. But if I could speak to the drinkers in particular at the moment, as I said, I was wondering how I would fare during this time if I was still drinking. And I know that there were a number of things that set off my drinking, and one of them was boredom. Another one was anxiety. And both of them are around in spades at the moment. Because you're confined. You can't go out and about too much. The pubs are closed. All the bars are shut. You know, the clubs are shut. So it's difficult to get a drink unless you go to a supermarket or go to an off-license. So there isn't that sort of sense of social, social interaction at the moment. It's just not there. And one of the things that was, for me before, was when I was drinking, was that I wasn't a very sociable person. But I like to go to pubs and be drinking with other people around about me. And part of the reason for that was because if they were all drinking, I wasn't drinking, then, you know, it was okay. You know, I wasn't out of place. But if I'm going out and buying drink and bringing it back, then, you know, people can see exactly what I'm doing. And by people, I mean people that matter. You know, my partner, my family, they can see exactly how much I'm drinking. The other thing is anxiety. There's a lot of anxiety going around at the moment. You know, will I get this virus? Will somebody else get this virus? Will my family get this virus? If I do get this virus, will it be serious? So there is a lot of anxiety going around just now. And to be honest, some of the reporting that's going on just now is really not helping that, because we're seeing some really negative reporting at the moment. We're seeing sort of all the sensationalist stuff that we weren't seeing at the beginning, because it was all kind of, you know, hey, we're in this together, let's fight it, you know, whoa. And now it's, as I say, we seem to have got past that, and we're now into the, this is wrong, that's wrong, this is how, you know, how it'll affect you, this is the symptoms, this is what it's like in intensive care, and, you know, and that's, a lot of this stuff is really quite anxiety provoking. I know that because I find it picking up myself, and I don't think I'm a particularly anxious person, but I'm picking up some of this negativity, I'm picking up some of this anxiety. And if I was drinking, then it would have been a very, very good excuse to drink. You know, so I have to find some positivity in here. You know, and one of the things I do is I come on and I sort of talk to you. I do things in bottled up, you know, so I'm keeping myself busy. I'm doing positive things. Right at the beginning, I wrote a blog post talking about this is an opportunity, you know, and I believe it is an opportunity. I believe if you're drinking at the moment, then, you know, you kind of have to look and say, well, how is this affecting me, you know? Am I having withdrawal symptoms? Now, some of you might be saying, oh, I don't shake, I don't sweat, I don't do this, I don't do that. Are you having mood swings? Are you feeling depressed? Yeah. Are you feeling bored? And some of that is actually, withdrawal symptoms. Because withdrawal symptoms aren't all physical. Some of them are psychological. Some of them are emotional. Yeah. So if you're beginning to feel that, then maybe it's time to sort of look and say, well, what can I do about this? What can I do about my drinking? And again, there's lots of stuff that's bottled up. Please have a look at it. Go and have a look at the assessment tools right at the front of Bottled Up. They will tell you if you are dependent on alcohol. They will tell you if this website will actually help you. So try it out. If you feel that you might have a problem with drinking, then this might be your best opportunity you've got. Because a lot of the pubs are shut down. A lot of the, you know, your escape is shut down. So use this for positive reasons. You know, do something positive. Change your life. Okay. And stay well. Bye.